Welcome to the VIQC Challenge referee training videos. The second episode, Chapter 2, is about robot rules and the proper match starting configuration for robots. We'll be discussing robot size, starting position, legal parts, and non-functional decorations. First, robot size limits. Overall robot size is typically checked once for each robot during the inspection process at the start of the event. Note that this year's starting requirements are different from past years. If any questions come up or you make changes to your robot, those can also be easily checked during the event as well. In VIQC Challenge Squared Away, Rule G4 states the following. At the beginning of a match, each robot must meet the following criteria. A. Only be contacting the floor and or the field perimeter. B. Fit within an 11-inch by 19-inch area, that's 279.4 millimeters by 482.6 millimeters, bounded by the starting position. Again, this can be checked using the field. The 19-inch dimension includes the inside of the field wall, but does not extend to the outside edge. C. Be no taller than 15 inches from the floor. This can be quickly checked with a measuring device, such as pre-measured VIQC parts snapped together, or the official VIQC robot sizing tool. Once the match begins, sizing is defined by Rule G5. During the match, robots may not expand beyond the following restrictions: horizontally, beyond an 11-inch by 19-inch area, or vertically, beyond the 15-inch high starting requirement, which of course is 381 millimeters. Violations of this rule will result in a warning for minor offenses that do not affect the match. Major or score-affecting offenses will result in a disqualification. This means that maximum horizontal sizes should also be checked during inspection. Pay close attention to the images found in R5 as well. It's important to note that this 11 by 19-inch horizontal area is not fixed. For example, if a robot has a mechanism which reaches out the front and the back, this is okay, as long as the whole robot never exceeds 11 by 19 inches at any given moment. Next, let's talk about what parts are allowed for use in the VIQC challenge. This is governed by R7, which states that robots may be built only from official robot components from the VIQC product line, unless otherwise specifically noted within these rules. This is pretty simple. If it's a VIQC part and can be found on vexrobotics.com or the VIQC legal parts appendix, then it's legal for use. That's it. Parts from other robotics kits, like the VIQC EDR metal robots, are not allowed. 3D printed parts that you make yourself are not allowed. Modified VIQC parts, no matter how small the modification, are not allowed either. Random parts that you may have from other projects, like zip ties, are not allowed. Parts that are not meant for robot construction, such as t-shirts, are definitely not allowed. There is one special exception to this rule. Most parts from the VIQC Robotics by Hexbug line that you can buy in retail stores are allowed. These parts can be a fun way to add some unique flair to your robot. Please note, however, that the electronics found in these kits are not allowed. We know that this may be a bit confusing, so when in doubt, just always remember to check the legal parts appendix. And finally, there is Rule R8, which states that robots may use appropriate non-functional decorations, provided that these do not affect robot performance in any significant way or affect the outcome of the match. These decorations can pretty much be anything you want, including all of the things that we just said aren't allowed, provided that they're safe, within the spirit of an educational event, and most importantly, do not provide any additional functionality to your robot. To achieve this, we encourage supporting or backing any decorations with legal VIQC parts. This way, if you were to take the decoration off of the robot, the functionality would stay exactly the same. Other than that, feel free to have some fun with it and make your VIQC challenge robot truly unique. These guidelines all make up a good starting point for what a referee should be looking for when preparing for a match. And that's all for Chapter 2. So thanks for watching, and make sure to check out the other videos in this series.